Hi, welcome to the Quantity Surveying Studio. In this video, I'll be showing you the basics of how quantity takeoff can be done from your drawings using the PlanShift software. Please make sure to watch this video till the end, and I'll show you how you can download this software completely for free. In this basic video, I'll be showing you how you can open your drawings in PlanShift software, how you can scale your drawings, how you can take off your countable quantities, how you can take off your linear measurements or your curved measurements, how you can take off your area, and also how you can take off your volume. So let's jump into the video. So this is how the PlanShift software looks like. So for opening a drawing, we need to go to New, give a name for your work or your job. I have given it a sample. Your job location will be local, because you can, if it is local, then you can select only the drawings which is inside your laptop or your PC. You cannot open any drawings that is in your server. It is mentioned here that you have selected local for the location of this job. This set of plans will only be available from this computer and not from any network. So you can click next. Then you can select your folder from where you are taking your drawing. So I have saved it in my desktop. It is saved as PlanShift. So you need to click on the drawings which you are selecting. After that, click next, again next, and next, finish. Slowly your drawing will be processing to get opened. So here your drawing has been opened in PlanShift. Now, before taking off any measurements, the first thing you need to do is to calibrate your drawings or set a scale for your drawings. There are two ways by which you can set your scale in PlanShift. The first one is by using the predefined scales that is already loaded in the software. So in your drawings, most drawings, the scale would have been mentioned. So in, for example, here the scale is 1:200. So you can check if this 1:200 scale has been already predefined in the software. For that, you can go to scale, click the drop down button, and you can check if 1:200 is available. So here it is available. So when you click, a disclaimer comes, so just click on agree. So if you see here beside your drawing, two arrow marks have come, which shows that your drawing has been scaled. Just double check it. You just need to check up a non-measurement. Just get a non-measurement and see if it is matching with the drawing. So here 20. So you can go to dimension, click the first point, and then click the last point. So here you got a measurement of 19.73, which is approximately equal to the measurement which is given in the drawing. So you can confirm that your drawing is okay. You can start your measurements. Your scale is okay and you can start your measurements. Now we'll look into the second method. Now in the second method of setting up your scale, this can be used when your scale has not been mentioned in the drawings and if you have a non-measurement available inside your drawings. So for that, you can just find a non-measurement from your drawing. Try to get a lengthy measurement so that your scale can be set more accurately. So for example, this is a tank figure here, and the width given here is 20 meters. So here it is mentioned 35 into 20 into 3.5 meters. So that means this measurement is 20 meters. So you know that this length is 20 meters. So what we can do is click on scale. Previously we had clicked on this drop down button, which is an arrow mark here, but now in the second method you need to click this part of scale, the top part of the scale. Once you click that, you need to enter your non measurement. So here in our example it is 20 meters, so click 20 meters. Here our measurement is in metric, so we are choosing metric here. So after clicking 20 meters, you can either select, if there are many drawings, you can click on this to set the scale for all the drawings. So here we are using only this one drawing, so no need to tick here. This we are ticking to automatically create a dimension line. So once you make a scale, that measurement will be shown in that scale. So once you click OK, just go to your first point and then go to your second point, final point. So here this dimension has been mentioned, 20 meter. If you look at in the drawing, besides your drawing, you can see a horizontal arrow. This means that the scale has been set for the horizontal scale. You can also set this drawing for a vertical scale. For that, you need to find out a vertical measurement. So we can see this is 35 meters. This tank length is 35 meters. So we can use this measurement. So again, go to scale. We know that the measurement is 35 meters. Again, click OK. Go to the first point. And go to the end point. Your dimension has been set. And if you see, a vertical arrow mark has also come. So this means your drawing has been set in both directions. So now once the drawings has been scaled properly, we'll start with our measurement, quantity takeoffs. So first we'll look into the countable measurement. So for example, we have some chambers here. We'll start counting the chambers. For that, you can go to count, click on top of it. We can give a name for the count. We'll give it as chamber. We can specify what type of countable shape we require. There are circle, square, plus, so we'll select circle, the color of that circle, and the style or the fill type of that circle, the pattern of that circle. So we'll just mention it as solid. After clicking OK, we can start counting. So we can click wherever we need to count. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's just assume that we need these 4 counts. So once that is finished, just click on digitize a record. So once the click is done, your drawing counts here. So chamber 4 numbers. So let's imagine that you have missed out some counts. For example, here 2-3 more chambers are there. So later on you're realizing that you need to add your count with these chambers. So for that, what you can do is click on any one circle or any one count, right click on it, click on continue with, click on with which type of item you need to add to this count. Click. So here we are adding to chamber, click on that, click OK. After that, you can start counting your missed items. So once that is done, here automatically, if you see below the cursor, your countable measurements are getting updated, and here also it is getting updated. Once it is complete, click digitize a record. So now it is updated. So this is how you can count your items. Now let's see how to take your linear measurements. For that, click on linear, give a name. So let's give a name as wall length. Again, you can select the color and your fill type. Click OK. So we are assuming that we are just want to measure the length from here till here. And that is finished. You click on digitize a record. So you got your wall length as 16 meters. Now if you need to continue measuring your wall, just again click on that wall measurement, right click on it, click continue with. You need to continue your wall measurement, so click wall, click OK, click the next point from where you want to continue measuring. Again, you're clicking here. Again, you need to click the bottom also. So you need to measure till here. So finally, you have done it. click digitize a record. So here your wall measurement gets updated to 48. Previously it was 16. So after calculating this part and this bottom part, it is coming to 48.8 meters. Now let's see how we can measure curved lengths. So for that, click on linear. Name your measurement. So we are measuring here as our pipe length. Select your color and fill type, press OK. And you can start your measurement. Once you reach your linear, the arc, just press A. Just press A and start your measurement. So click next point. And until your arc is finished, keep pressing A. After that, release the A button. So you can continue your measurement. So here, if you see, your arc has been measured accurately. And then you can press on digitize a record. So here you get your pipe measurement as 2.9, taking in account the arc shape also. Now let's see how you can find the area. For that, click on area. Give the name of that area. Let's assume that we are taking the area of the tank 1. Select the color and fill type, press OK. Now you need to select the 4 points to measure the area. So first point, second point, the third point, finally the fourth point. Once it is done, click on digitize a record, and here your tank 1 697.1 square meters. That will be your area. If you need to cut anything inside this area, for example, if you want to cut this much part, just right click on this area, click on subtract from section, click on the 4 points which you need to deduct. So we are deducting this much part. So it should be inside this area. So once that is done, click on digitize a record. So this push part has been deducted. So your it was previously 690 something, that has been reduced to 527 area. This area will be minus 169.31 square meters. So that has been deducted from the total area. Now let's see how you can calculate the volume. For that, let's assume here it is given as 3.5 meter as the depth. So first measure the area. Here we will rename as tank 2. Click the 4 points. Click on digitize a record. So once you found out the area, what you can do is right click on it, go to properties, click on advanced. Inside takeoff data, you can mention the depth. So here it is 3.5 meters and click OK. So again, you can go to properties, advanced. You go to takeoff data, you can find that volume is 2440 cubic meters. So this is the way how you can find the volume by mentioning the depth. Click on OK. So I hope this is clear. Now, as I mentioned in the beginning of the video on how you can get the PlanSwift software for free, just mention your email ID in the comment section so that I can send you the installation file to your email ID, and you can use it to install it into your computer, and you can practice your quantity takeoffs using this PlanSwift software. So hope this video was informative. For more informative videos Please do subscribe to this channel and keep learning. Stay safe. Thank you for watching this video. Bye.